Hello Internet, Oscar Vlies again, this time with the video on power method for finding eigenvalues. We'll go over some examples, talk about the inverse power method, and also the Rayleigh quotient. First, let's define some notation. The eigenvalue will represent using the letter lambda, the eigenvector will represent using the letter v, and the pair of them we call the eigenpair. This is the definition of an eigenvalue, where if multiply a times the eigenvector v, we get lambda times that vector. And eigenvalues have all sorts of applications, from solving equations to differential equations to applications in physics and geology, you name it. Let's look at an example of the eigenvalue. If we take this matrix, 0, negative 4, 2, negative 6, and we multiply it by the eigenvector of 1, 1, what we're left with is the value of negative 4 times 1, 1. This means our negative 4 is the eigenvalue and 1, 1 is the eigenvector. We can do the same thing with the eigenvector of 2, 1. We're left with the eigenvalue of negative 2. Let's look at a common approach to finding eigenvalues called the power method, which is given by this function here. Don't worry, we're going to go through some examples. Here, A is an n by n matrix, and B is an n element vector. We're going to take the norm, which is simply the maximum of this matrix multiplication. And to start with, we'll usually use random numbers for B. We'll repeat the process until B is equal to itself, and then that's when we find our eigenvector and our eigenvalue. Let's try to find the eigenvalues of this matrix 0, 1, 1, 1 using power method, starting from the vector 1, 1. We multiply the matrix times the vector to get the result of 1, 2. Then we normalize it, simply finding the maximum of the vector, in this case 2. Then we divide it out from 1, 2, giving us 0.5, 1. Then we restart the process. Multiply our matrix times 0.5 and 1, giving us the value of 1, 1.5, finding the maximum, which is 1.5, and dividing it out, leaving us with the result of 0.666 repeating and 1. Let's look at a more streamlined version of this process. If we take our example matrix and our starting vector, we multiply our matrix times our vector, and then factor out a 2. Then multiply our matrix times our new vector and factor out a 1.5. We repeat the process, and eventually we converge to this eigenpair of 1.618 as their eigenvalue and 0.6181 as their eigenvector. The nice thing about power method is that this process of multiplying and factoring works on most any matrix, although it can be slow depending on how your eigenvalues are configured, and it only finds the dominant eigenvalue, meaning the one that is largest in absolute value. What if you wanted to find a smaller eigenvalue? This is where you want to use the inverse power method, which is simply power method applied to the inverse of matrix A. It looks something like this. The inverse of a matrix multiplied by its original will give us the identity matrix. And here's an easy way to solve for the inverse of a 2x2 matrix. If we apply it to our matrix 0, 1, 1, 1 that we've been using earlier, we get the matrix negative 1, 1, 1, 0. And indeed, if we multiply our original matrix A times its inverse, we get the identity. So let's apply the power method to that inverse of matrix A, starting from the same vector of 1, 1. Multiply, factor out 1, multiply, factor out 1. Repeat the process, and then eventually, this sequence actually starts to loop between two eigenvectors. Although we're not quite done. The inverse power method only finds an eigenvector. We still need to compute its corresponding eigenvalue. And the way to do that is simply to take our original matrix and multiply it by the eigenvector that we found. Then factor out the value to make it so that our eigenvector will equal itself. In this case, we factor out negative 0.618. You have to do the same thing for the other eigenvector that we found, and indeed this has the same eigenvalue. Another way you could find the eigenvalue given an eigenvector is to use the Rayleigh quotient, which is this function here. Why it works is a bit beyond the scope of this video, but as an example, let's plug in the eigenvector that we found earlier, and indeed this does give us our eigenvalue of negative 0.618. In fact, you can actually use this quotient even if your eigenvector is not exact. Let's take one of our earlier values for b, and if you plug this into our quotient, we still get the same eigenvalue. So far, we've been able to find two eigenvalues, one using power method to find the dominant eigenvalue, and the other using the inverse power method. But what if we wanted to find even more eigenvalues? The algebraic way of finding an eigenvalue is by using the determinant, giving this expression here, set it equal to 0, and solve it using variables for lambda. In this case, you would say lambda squared minus lambda minus 1 is equal to 0, which you can solve either using the quadratic equation, or if you've seen my video on Horner's method, you can solve it using that. Or use the same idea of saying a minus some subtraction times the identity to come up with the inverse power method with a shift, which looks like this, where mu is a guess or a close approximation of an eigenvalue. We usually just refer to this expression as also just inverse power method. And it's also a nice way to compute the eigenvector given an eigenvalue. Here's an example of that inverse power method shifted in action. We'll give it a guess, a value from mu, of negative 0.5. We plug this into inverse power method. The matrix we'll be operating now is now negative 6, 4, 4, minus 2, which we simply plug into power method, starting from the vector 1, 1. After 7 iterations, we're able to find our eigenvector, and we apply the Rayleigh quotient to it to find our eigenvalue. We actually could have applied the quotient even earlier, at the 4th iteration, to come up with our eigenvalue. This idea of applying the Rayleigh quotient early and often is the basis behind the Rayleigh quotient iteration. You simply take inverse power method, but always apply the Rayleigh quotient, which looks like this. With initial values from mu and b given close approximations to the eigenvalue and vector, after every step, we'll update mu sub k using the Rayleigh quotient. This does mean we do need to compute a new inverse at every step, but hopefully it will converge to the eigenvalue that much faster. Some final thoughts. Both power method and inverse power method have linear orders, but you can speed things up using the Rayleigh quotient. And in fact, Rayleigh quotient iteration actually has a cubic or convergence order. There are many other eigenvalue methods out there. These are not the only three. And MATLAB even has two of them built in when you call the eig function. As always, the code that I used in these examples will be hosted on GitHub. Sincerely, thank you for watching. I hope you found this video on eigenvalues helpful. If there are any other topics that you'd like me to make videos for, please be sure to suggest them in the comments.